Let's start with turning real photos into short video clips. Using my personal photography as an input for image-to-video workflow. This allows me to revisit some of the moments that I've shot in real life over the years. Forever frozen in time, they are in a way brought back to life with a few seconds of believable simulation. In my opinion, it is both strange and wonderful, especially when it gets it right, like in this case. And here are some of the experiments with turning personal art into short video sequences. Once again, using a variety of tools for image-to-video processing, I'm choosing my own 3D and 2D art as an input. For example, having a go at this 3D render of a 2nd century AD head of Bodhisattva with the help of Runway's Gen 3 model. Here's another abstract render of an eye. The animation took a radical turn here. This is also ran through Gen 3 by Runway. For this piece, I asked for a dramatic zoom-out camera movement using Luma AI's Dream Machine. And here are three different results of the same digital art piece processed through Kyber AI. This is a crop from a big psychedelic illustration I made. Two different results for this version. And two more for a dark neon light version. I love how it animated the lighting effects on the face. This was also ran through Kyber AI. I have a series of abstract digital art patterns that I've created a long time ago. Here they are animated with the help of Runway's Gen 3 and Gen 2 models. Now, I know Gen 2 is an obsolete model, but in this case, it produced a rather interesting looking result. Gen 3, once again. Using this render of ancient Buddhist sculpture one more time, I want to demonstrate another method that I use a lot while working with generative video. I call it layering. What it is basically is stacking multiple AI outputs together, obtained from the same source clip but using different styles or seeds. For blending these layers together, I use Adobe After Effects and Premiere Pro, a simple yet fast way to produce an interesting result. This right here is a self-portrait I created many years ago during my active days as a psychonaut. This illustration is really big, so I cropped out the face and fed it into Magnific AI to try and turn this piece into a marble mosaic of sorts. It worked just as I envisioned it. You can see individual bits of marble nicely put together, just like in the real mosaic. I'm not sure if blue or purple marble actually exists in nature, but even if not, we'll just pretend it was sourced on a different planet. And if I want to proceed and generate a video clip of this marble portrait, I can. Prompted to include additional details such as bits of stained glass, gold, and precious stones. I think this is rather marvelous. As an artist, I find it is highly satisfying to see your work reimagined so effortlessly in a new form. Now, let's take this processed illustration and feed it alongside a few other images into Midjourney as image prompts, style, and characters. On the output, you'll be surprised with a new set of artworks, all containing an aspect of your own art in itself. The resulting mixture can be further guided by text prompts and animated. Here's another psychedelic illustration from my collection that I use a lot as an input in my generations. I can feed it into Runway's Gen 3 to see what it would look like as a neon lit animation. Or I can apply my previous recipe to this image and mix it up with a couple other images to produce another set of unique looking trippy artworks, which again can be turned into a short animated film in a matter of a couple hours. I still feel intoxicated with this level of freedom